Asante sana. Mimi naitwa DPP. Na siku ya leo tuko na Gedhaiga hapa. Atakuwa kituelezea how did he receive the news na atakuwa kituelezea hadi saizi what is his view about the death of Chira. Karibu sana Gedhaiga.
Asante. Mm-hmm. So my name is Samuel Gedhaiga. So how I received the news? First and foremost, I'm here at City Mortuary to confirm that it is indeed true that our brother Brian Chira has left us. It is devastating that we received the news so early. Brian Chira was a young man full of life. He was a young man full of ambition. He is a young man who promised the entire nation that he would be something out of himself. Brian Chira was an example of young people who stand up for themselves and fight for themselves and eventually become something in the society. So personally, as Samuel Gidega, I'm here to confirm that a brother has left me. Brian Chira was a brother. He's a man who we talked a lot. Remember, he's a young person who came out living with HIV. I am a HIV activist. And so when I come here, I came to confirm that one of my brothers and one of the young champions that we have in Kenya has left us so tragically. Yeah.
And how did you receive the news?
Well, the news is tragic. It is devastating. It is breaking. I cannot even try to imagine that we will ever, ever have another Brian Chira. Nobody can ever fit the shoes that Brian Chira aliva. Hakuna mtu ambaye anaweza kureplace the gap that Brian Chira has left. Mm-hmm. Brian Chira lived so well for my people. We have spoken with him before. He has told me that all he wanted was to make sure that we have a safer society. And for young people living with HIV in Kenya, I am here to confirm that we have suffered one of the greatest losses in our history. Mm-hmm. A young person who is a public figure who came out living with HIV, and within a moment, a shot watcher. It is totally devastating. It is breaking. I received the news yesterday night. I could not even sleep. But mambo ya God, tunachia Mungu. It is God who gives, and it is God who has taken. Yeah.
Do you have any idea of what really happened?
So I don't have an idea of what happened. I can't prove, but from the information we get is that Brian Chira got an accident at the wee hours of Jana Asubuhi, and it is so devastating. What I would like to ask is, tafadhali madereva wetu, as we are doing this, as we are driving, as we are looking for our hustles, let us be considerate. Let us look on our roads. Najua saizi mambo ni ngumu, labda hatuwezi blame mtu for now, but let us be considerate, because I don't think this pain that Brian Chira has left can be justified for anything. So I would like to urge our drivers, even as we drive, even at night, let us remember that these young people muna condemn, these young people munasema ni walevi, they are our sons, they are our brothers, they are people who had an impact on our society. So let us be careful on our roads. I wish we could bring back Brian. It is the most devastating news I've had in so many years. Yeah.
And maybe, do you record the last moments that you had with Brian Chira? How was it?
We have been speaking with Brian. I spoke with him on a TikTok live around 2 weeks ago, and Brian was full of life. We kept on talking to each other kwa social media zetu ambazo ni kama WhatsApp, and Brian had no issue. Brian was a young man who was struggling in his own levels, and he did everything to fight for his own self. Brian wanted to prove to the whole world that indeed you can be young, indeed you can have issues, but you can still come out a winner. That is what I remember Brian for. Brian was a fighter. He fought for all of us. He fought battles I would never fight as Samuel Gidega. When Brian met me, or when I met Brian the first time, he told me, Gidega, I want you to hold my hands because I want to help my people. But I saw in Brian something that I could not see in myself. Brian was a fighter and he fought for our people. So yeah.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Yeah. So maybe you are so close to Brian.
Yeah.
So many people maybe they want to see what next from now.
What next from now? Is to urge all communities, our community. I would also urge the TikTok family to mourn Brian in peace. Brian has left us. I would also ask that we wait for plans. Baba Talisha and others who are friends to Brian as well are on top of things. They will inform us in due time. Tukwe wapole. Na from now henceforth, tungoje words from them. But as we wait from words from them, I want to ask all community members and all TikTokers ya kwamba ni waulize tunazika moja wetu. Tumewachwa na moja wetu. Brian Chira gonna be the unifying factor. Tumechukiana, tumepigana, tumezozeana, lakini for Brian Chira we gonna come together to fight for him and to be there for him at the last minute. Brian never wanted people to hate each other. Brian stood for peace. Brian stood for people working together. And that is the spirit that I want to urge everybody to come with it at the last minute of Brian. Chira, nikiangalia picha zake za juzi, wale watu walikuwa na yeye pale, alikuwa ana have fun. He was full of life. He was a happy person. Brian lived a happy life. Irregardless of what people saw, Brian lived a happy life. He had his own struggles. He fought to deal with them. And it is my prayer and it is my call that you take Brian to rest as people who are united and as people who believed and who believe in the same principles that Brian believed in. That is the best honor we can give to Brian Chira. Thank you.
So maybe what is that one thing that you'll never forget about Brian Chira?
I will never forget the fact that Brian Chira stood up for my people. I'm one person living with HIV. We have 2.5 million people living with HIV. But Brian Chira was among the first people who came out to be people in public and people in limelight. And he was never embarrassed to say that he's a person living with HIV. I am here because I am burying a champion. I am here because I am mourning a champion. I am here because I am mourning somebody who gave life and hope to thousands of young people living with HIV. Brian Chira was a TikToker and a friend to me, but he was also a person who stood up for our people. And anytime I had a conversation with Brian, he was always telling me, "Githega mnakunywa dawa? Githega watu wetu wanaenda vizuri?" Those were his words. He always asked me that. And Brian stood up for my people. I will remember him as a champion, as a person who was never embarrassed to stand up for my people. That is my memory for Brian Chira.
Yeah, so you mean you have not been given any permission to view his body?
So I came and I spoke with the attendant. He could not allow me to view his body. Not because I haven't viewed it. I have viewed it on online picture. And it's unfortunate that we could not view it because of course, the limelight that comes with it. There are some of us who never believed that this could happen. There are some of us who are maybe ambitious enough maybe to share the photos. And it's unfortunate that the photos of Brian Chira atakuwa mepass zina spread online. And it's because of those photos that I was denied the chance to view him. But I wasn't denied the chance. I was told tomorrow, after ametengenezwa vizuri, I can be able to come na niweze kumuona kesho. So Brian Chira, it's not like tumekatazwa kumuona. It is just like we have to control the public pictures that are spreading all over. Na pia familia yake. Ningeuliza kila mtu aombe familia yake. Tunajua vile Brian alipenda cousins wake wawili na alipenda shosho yake. So let us stand with them even in these times. Tusijaribu kuwa torment.
If you cannot spread the photos of your son when he's dead, if you cannot spread the photos of your brother when he's dead, if you cannot spread the photos of anybody close to you, akiwa kwa hiyo hali, we cannot justify spreading the photos of Brian Chira. So again, I would also ask bloggers ambao walikuja na wakaona Brian Chira na wakampiga picha, let us try to maintain his dignity. Brian Chira would never stand for anything that in a less ama in a lower dignity ya mtu as a human being. Let us stand and maintain his dignity as a human being. He was our brother, for crying out loud. Let us be considerate of him and let us be considerate of his family.
Ya kwa mtu ambaye anatazama pale, tungependa kujua maybe Chira alikuwa anaishi wapi na alikuwa maybe anaishi na nani.
So the farthest I know Brian Chira, nikimjua personally as at a personal level, I knew him in Nakuru. I knew him around 2 years ago as a young community member, a person who was very determined to achieve everything he could in life. And then I came to meet him in public limelight ile wakati wa accident. Brian Chira was an ambassador of good and safe driving kwa barabara. He is known and we all know him as a person who stood up na akasema ya kwamba barabara zetu zinafaa kuwa na signs za zebra crossings na signs za mahali ambapo watu wanapitia. Brian, in simple terms, I would call him as an ambassador who tried as much as he could kujaribu kusimamisha zile accident ambazo zina happen kwa barabara. It is so unfortunate that we lost him that way. After nimemjua kutoka Nakuru, alikuja Nairobi. After, of course, people came out and said that this is our son and this is a person who needs limelight, anafaa kusaidiwa na kusupportiwa. And that is when he came to Ruaka. He lived in Ruaka the latest time that I knew him. And he was very okay there. He made friends. Hata hiyo siku ambayo alituacha, alikuwa na marafiki. He had friends, he made friends. Brian Chira was a social person. And you asked me where he lived.
Yeah.
He lived in Ruaka.
Okay. Tukimaliza, kuna mtu angependa baby kujua kama kuna any support, mtu ambaye anataka kutuma any support atatuma wapi ama.
Ningependa kuhimiza tafadhali. We have people who are very close to Brian Chira because Brian Chira was all our darling. He was all our friends. Everybody has somewhere ameguzwa na maisha ya Brian Chira. Kila mtu ako na part of his life ameguzwa na maisha ya Brian Chira. All of us will be very interested to know where to maybe to give support. Lakini ningependa kuhimiza, since we have Baba Talisha and the entire TikTok team that was there with him during his time when he was struggling with alcohol and things like that, ningependa kuhimiza tungoje tupate information kutoka kwa Baba Talisha, because Baba Talisha has been picked as the person who will link his friends and fans with his family. So I would like to support his family and encourage his family. Na pia ningependa tuheshimu familia yake kwa kungoja ile kitu ambayo tutaambiwa na Baba Talisha na his closest friends. And after we have learned what to do, I want to ask, and this is the most important point, I want to ask everybody who was touched, everybody who knew Brian Chira, to come up and to come out for him during this time. We were not prepared for this, but we'll be there for him. We will wait for communications, na tutam support, kulingana na vile tutambiwa. Thank you.
So thank you very much, Kidaika, for giving us your time.
Yes.